All right, what up, guys? Your boy Retro is back. I've been meaning to do a video on this for the last few days, going over the TCG ban list coming up for April 1st. Let's take a look at some of the changes that were made and some of the surprises that I noticed. Let's first start off with Sinister Serpent, which is now at one. Not really a big deal. I mean, people wouldn't even use this card. I don't really see a deck that would benefit this card. One of the bigger surprises, though, is Tour Guide of the Underworld is now limited to one. Now, it's going to affect a lot of decks. It's going to affect a lot of the Burning Abyss deck. It's going to affect my Archfiend deck. Tour Guide of the Underworld is one of those cards where you can just fit into any deck. And the fact that you can have three at one point down to one, it's going to make some changes, because if you negate that with Fiendish Chain, Breakthrough Skill, Effect Veiler, you're pretty much stuck with a dead card, because Tour Guide of the Underworld, besides the effect, is practically a useless card. So now that's the one that's going to change things. Before, it's like, okay, it gets Veilered, Fiendish Chain, okay, got another one, doesn't matter. Now it's like, I only have one, so you got to make that one count, hopefully. They did bring this card back, Dragon Ravine back, was banned, but now it's limited to one. Preparation of Rites for the Necro players. Sacrifice for the Cleeports. Symbol of Heritage. One of the cards that was interesting that has been on the ban list since who knows when, probably, I don't even think this card's ever been used, is Temple of the Kings, which is a card that I've actually stuck into one of my decks. The ability to activate a trap card the same turn it was set once per turn. That is a good card. In a lot of decks that you will wish could have been a quick play, but it wasn't, so Temple of the Kings allows it to be played the same turn it's set. They brought back one of my favorite cards, Crush Card, and when I noticed the Crush Card reprint of the text, it's different from what it used to be. Real quick, target one dark monster with 1,000 or less attack. Your opponent takes no battle damage until the end of next turn. That's new. That effect wasn't there on the old Crush Card that I remember. Also, look at your opponent's hand and all monsters they control, and if you do, destroy anything over 1,500. Before, this used to automatically, destroy their hand for anything over 1,500. And then here's the crazy effect. Then your opponent can destroy up to three monsters from with 1,500 or more attack from their deck. So on some decks like Shedalls, or that could actually be a benefit. The fact that you can destroy monsters in your deck. There's a few decks that actually could benefit off of that effect. That effect wasn't there before, which was something new. Another card off the ban list is Exchange of the Spirit. Ring of Destruction is back, one of my favorite cards that I liked back in the old days. Soul Drain is limited to one. Used to be three, now it's one. So kind of makes some of the decks even more powerful, like Necros, of course. A lot of the cards these days are all based on effects, so I thought Soul Drain should have probably been one anywhere. Vanity's Emptiness. Cleeport Scout, Necro's Baryonic, which is a cheese card. The deck in general was cheese. That's all. That's limited. Well, not limited, I guess. Well, yes, limited to two. Charge of the Light Brigade for the Light Swarms. Sacred Star is back to two. It was banned, but because they banished the Dragon Rulers, I guess this card has value and fairness now. Because before, you could banish the Dragon Rulers gain their effects and all that crazy stuff. Brotherhood of the Firefist Spirit is three. Bestiary is three. And a lot of people have been talking about this, how Bestiary was so good back in the day. The fact that it's at three now doesn't really make a difference to the deck. The Gladiator Beasts aren't what they used to be. I've tried to use them, and it's just too much that can stop Gladiator Beasts. It's a lot of things that move faster than Gladiator Beasts. So Bestiary at three. If you could have told me that about 3 or 4 years ago, I would have said this amazing thing, but it's not really that big a deal anymore. Gore's at three, Lonefire Blossom at three. These Dragon Rulers, these little, I guess, off-brand version of Dragon Rulers, which have taken over for the Dragon Rulers. You can run three of each, the wind, earth, and water, and fire, and Heretic Seal. Goyo is back at three now. Interesting. Goyo isn't the same card as it used to be. Like Bestiary, Goyo Guardian and Bestiary used to run. Well, some of the cards used to just run the TCG back then. and those cars aren't as popular, nor they had the same effect as they used to. So now they made them at three, and it's not even a big deal. Like I said, had you had done that 4 years ago, they would have been overpowered and cheesed. Legendary Six Samurai, I hate this card so much. I hate this card when somebody plays a Six Samurai deck, especially if they go first, and they make this card so easily because it's only 5 stars. It's easy to get out. I hate that card. And the Dragon Rules are banned, as I mentioned, and so is Snatch Steel. I can't tell you how many games I've lost on Snatch Steel. I've lost so many games off of Snatch Steel that when they put it back on the ban, when they put it back on the list for cards that are playable at the beginning of the year, I was like, "That's not a good idea." Of course, with my Archfiend deck, I can just use Falling Down. That's my personal Snatch Steel. I can run three of them. But anyway, Snatch Steel is a cheese card. I hate it, but you gotta deal with it. So that is the ban list for the TCG. I'm just gonna really scroll over the OCG, Bryonic, Magician of Chaos, Mathematician, Curry Bandit. I'm not gonna go touch on El Shaddoll Fusion. Nobody really plays the OCG, so these are just kind of like some things. As you can see, Arcalor Krista is at three, which is interesting. Yeah, that card used to be limited to one. Insector Horn is now at one. Temple of Kings, Monster Gaze at one. I mean, it's worth mentioning for people who are in OCG, but we don't usually play by OCG rules. We usually play by TCG, so they're worth mentioning. But so that is the new list coming up for April 1st. So leave your comments in the comment section below. Let me know what you think. Those are just my thoughts, and wanted to get that video out. Appreciate it, guys. Like, comment, subscribe. I'm out.